A little while ago, Tesla added live Sentry Cam footage to their app, which means that if we go into the security tab and we click view live camera, give it a little second to load, and now I can see myself from the car's camera and I'm waving. Becky, give it a wave. How nice is that? And in this video, I will be testing this feature to its limits, starting at the rear of the vehicle. Follow me down here, everybody, because it's not just the front camera that you can now view from the app. We can also view the rear camera. Get ready for this, everyone. You ready? Hello, everyone. And you can see, yes, the FPS is slightly low, but that is to be expected considering it is a completely live feed. And just like the front and rear cameras, we can also view the side cameras. Whereabouts is it? It's just in there. Give it a little wave. Becky, give it a wave once again. Yay! And now I'll see you on the other side. Click it. And here I am. Hello there, everybody. So this is a very, very useful feature because it means that if you're leaving your car at an airport for 2 weeks and then you get a notification that there's some Sentry. Oh, I've just noticed my ass is just the whole thing in the camera. Look at that. But yes, for security purposes, this is a great feature because if you're leaving your car at an airport for 2 weeks and then you get a notification that there's something suspicious going on with your car, you can go onto the live feed and you can make sure everything's okay. And if you see someone doing something suspicious near your car, you can click the flash lights button and try and scare them off. And if that doesn't deter them, there's even a horn button as well, which I'm not going to click because we're currently in a nature reserve. But one drawback with this live feed is that it only works if the car is in park. I want to see in this video if we can trick it into working when the car is on the move. So let's head inside the car. So now that I'm in the car, you will see that when I click view live camera, I cannot view the live camera. Camera's unavailable. Make sure no one is in the car and all doors are closed. But this is where the tricking begins. You want to see my first trick? I am going to exit the vehicle. You stay right there, please, Becky. Close the door. Becky is still in the car, but if I click refresh, wait for it, wait for it, wait for it. Oh, now it works. Even though there is still technically someone in the car, but I can still view the live feed. I'm waving at myself. Great stuff. But now what I want to do is I want to use Becky's phone that also has the Tesla app and see if I can move the car while still having access to the live camera feed. Oh, I've been locked out. Error. Connection to vehicle lost. Please try again. Okay, let's refresh for a moment. Okay, I've regained access to the live camera, but on Becky's phone, I've now been locked out of the summon. So far, I'm being beaten here. So in that case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to see, can we open the boot with the live camera still active? All right, I can see access to the boot. I'm going to click open. Oh, yes, we can. We've got a beautiful laggy shot of the boot opening. Stay right there, Becky. I'll give it a little wave. That's right, Tesla, get hacked. And now we're gonna close the boot. The car's locking, and the boot has closed, and we got to see the whole thing on the live camera. Ah!
No!
The car is not happy with me right now. Just banged my glasses as well. Right, let's get access to the camera because it keeps locking me out. Okay, I'm attempting. All right, so it's not letting me summon when I've already got the app open. But what if we try and summon first, and then while the car's on the move, that's when we try and access the live camera. So I'm about to summon the car with Becky's phone right now. So you will see that the car is on the move. Don't worry, guys, I'll walk with you. And now I'm going to turn Sentry mode on. Sentry mode failed. I'm going to try and click it again. Sentry mode failed. The aircon's come on. What's going on? The car is angry. Okay, right. Hi, everyone. Today, I tried to beat the Tesla live cam and make it work while the car was moving. And the most that I was able to do was open the boot. Okay, so how could this live Sentry Cam feature be improved? Well, obviously it would require some kind of cloud storage, but I think you should be able to look at recent Sentry Cam history right from your phone, just like you can do from within the car. Because obviously, if your car's far away from you and you get a notification that there's some weird Sentry Cam activity, by the time you click that notification, it might be too late, you might have missed it. Obviously, you'd be able to look at the footage when you got back into the car, but if your car is stolen, then that would not be the case. I also think the Sentry Cam feed should allow access to this little interior camera as well, because it is your car after all. So if your car's stolen, that's how you'd be able to have video evidence of them stealing your car. Because currently Tesla owners can't access that camera, only Tesla themselves can. If you've got any other improvement ideas for this feature, let me know in the comments down below. Thank you very, very much for watching. It is nice to do another Jack Massey Welsh video. Thanks to 550,000 subscribers, and we'll see you later.